how to add slides to your video in Shotcut to help engage viewers and make your explanations easier to follow. Let's head over to the computer and get started.
So to start with, I have created a new Shotcut project, added a few clips into the playlist, and then put them into the timeline. For the purposes of this demonstration, I'm imagining that this is my finished video, and this is the thing that I want to add my slides on top of. So let's set that up. First of all, come over to the three dots, track operations, and add video track. The new video track is where we will add all of our slides. Now that's great, but we also need a set of slides to add. So now you need to go over to your favorite slide presentation software and create the slides. For this demonstration, I'm using Impress, which is LibreOffice, but Microsoft PowerPoint or Canva or anything like that will also work the same way. So first of all, create your slides in the software. Once you've done that, you basically want to work backwards. So if I demonstrate what I've created here, it starts off with freebies, and then it goes to the video editing checklist, ultimate YouTuber framework, and video creator framework, and then it all kind of fades out a little bit, and free downloads link in the description. Maybe that's something that you wanted on your slides, or maybe you wanted something just like a list going down the page. Entirely up to you, but we're just using this as an example. And for reference, all of these documents are actually available on my website in the link below. So coming out of slideshow mode and then entering into how we would need to set these up for Shotcut. Now, Shotcut only accepts still images, so you're not going to be able to make fancy transitions from your slideshows to the Shotcut project. However, you can replicate those transitions once it's all in Shotcut. So what do I mean? Well, what we need to do is every time you've got a transition or an animation on your slides, you need to make a new image. So the easiest thing to do here is to duplicate your slides as many times as you have transitions. What I mean by that is every single time you click next or a new transition happens on the screen, you want a new slide. If that doesn't make sense, then bear with me. It should in just a few moments' time. On my slideshow here, I had 5 transitions, so I've now got 5 slides. So now you've got the amount of transitions that you need in your project, and you've got the same image for each of them at the moment. What we're going to do now is go through each one in turn so we actually see what the transition should show us. So image one, when we first start off, we don't want any of this stuff. We don't want anything at all. It's just the word freebies on the screen. For number two, we want to get rid of most of it, but we want to keep the video editing checklist. For slide 3, we want to add in the ultimate YouTuber framework. For slide 4, we want all 3 of them to show, and then slide 5, we want the fade out and the link in description image to show next. So effectively, this is now the slideshow. Hopefully you can start to see this coming together, and now we can export each one of these images and then add them into Shotcut.
Now, just before we continue, if we're meeting for the very first time, then my name is Joe and this channel helps YouTubers edit their videos and use free software. If you're creating YouTube videos regularly and not seeing the growth you'd hope for, you're probably missing one or more elements of the video creator framework. You can download the free PDF in the description below to get started. Now, let's get back to the video.
You might have to do this in slightly different ways depending on your package, but for me, I come up to File, I click on Export, and then I select JPEG. You can do JPEG or JPG, it doesn't really matter. I would suggest selecting an image format rather than a PDF file for Shotcut though. Make sure you're in the right location, and then click Save. Depending on the application, you may also get some options. Now you click save. Now for me, I have to do that for each and every one of them. Otherwise it won't export every file. As you do that, make sure you're using names that make sense. Once you have all of the images saved, you can then import them into Shotcut. Now back in Shotcut, we can add our slides one at a time and then modify them as we see fit. By default, they come onto the screen at 4 seconds long, and you would probably want to change them for each slide. Now you can butt them up to one another so they don't really transition past, they just show one image after another. Let me just demonstrate that. So it goes from one image to the next, and the quality of my screen is because I've got proxy and preview scaling on, but these will render at full quality. But the basic slideshow is now in Shotcut. To make that look a little bit better, you might want to transition from one slide to another, and you can do that by overlapping each of the video files. So now it will fade in just like it does in the actual presentation folder. As with Shotcut, you can also add any of the filters or anything else on there that you want. So if I demonstrate with this clip, if I wanted this to be maybe be half the size of the screen, I could add in size, position, rotate, resize the frames, and then let's imagine you're on the screen and you can also have your slideshow presenting to the side. You could also do it the other way around, where you have your slides maximized and then you in the small bottom corner, which is quite a common scenario, especially when you're presenting a long presentation. Now, this style is actually better for short presentations or lists that you want to run through very quickly on screen. It's not made really for full presentations because you'll be doing the work effectively twice. If you wanted to do full presentations, then I recommend using a screen recorder, which will enable you to record your screen and your webcam at the same time, instead of having to do this method for a full presentation.
Please consider liking and subscribing, and before you go, click or tap on the video on your screen right now, and it will continue to help you with Shotcut. I'll see you in the next video.